So let's talk about these stripes.
Okay, so the stripes are, they're a little confusing sometimes for us because trying to do like the negative space, you know what I mean?
Like it can be confusing and difficult, people. That's what she's trying to say.
Yeah. So basically what you want to do is you want to figure out how wide you want your stripes to be. Mm-hmm. I like pretty wide.
I do too, because if you have a whole bunch of small stripes, first of all, it's going to be a disaster to paint. Second of all, you're going to walk into the room and you're going to go, oh God, my eyes.
Dizzying.
Yeah. And small patterns, not good.
Buzz.
So we measured our stripes out to 8 inches and just taped them off. And all it takes is a ruler and an eyebrow pencil.
And a friend. So we measured 8 inches and we literally marked down 8 inches and we just kind of keep marking it down on the wall to make sure it's straight. And like I said, you grab your friend and you just pull that tape and hopefully it's straight.
Hopefully it's straight. You got to take a lot of steps back just to make sure. And measure. We cannot stress that enough. That is the key to having straight stripes, people.
And I know that some people do like a razor ruler kind of thing. And actually, that would probably be really great. But we don't know how to use that. And we like to use what we can. So we grab some painting tape, a pencil, an eyebrow pencil, if that works best because it rubs right off the wall, and a friend and get to it. Primer is really important because it creates like a gritty surface, so it's almost a little bit sandy, so your paint just adheres to it that much better. So you have less coats to do, it ultimately ends up being easier in the long run, and you don't want that paint peeling right off, especially high gloss on something, it will peel off.
Yeah, so make sure you primer. And we chose a gray primer because it went kind of with the blue, and it was just kind of a good neutral base to start with.
Yes, and our paint dude told us that. So go to your paint professionals and ask them. They will guide you. A lot of times you have to do a separate primer because high gloss doesn't come with primer combined. But if you're doing a matte, you can do it combined, make it a little easier too. Mm-hmm. So there's lots of options out there. You just need to ask.